come to you. We say, hallowed be your name. We sing the praise this morning. As your people hear your word, let your word bring forth signs. Let your word bring forth deliverance. And let your people possess their possession. Take the heaviness control this hour. And let all the glory be given unto you. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us have a seat. In the name of God, we want to welcome every one of us to God's presence, and as many of us who are tuned to hear God's words by various social media means, we pray that the power of God will reach out unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The topic for our exhortation this morning is Jesus, our comforter. Jesus, our comforter. There's no better and most relevant topic, not an act of coincidence, that this topic has been selected or chosen. It is by divine purpose and plan for the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion that today we are being asked to speak on this topic, our comforter. In a time like this, where answers are nowhere, we are confident in the Lord that indeed He is our comforter. Tell yourself, Jesus is my comforter. I take my text from John's Gospel, chapter 11. I read verse 23. Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." As simple as that statement, it has so much to speak about positivity. It has so much to speak about hope. It has so much to speak about the future and the tomorrow. In the midst of hopelessness, in the midst of no certainty, when all hope was lost, we find Jesus Christ in this picture ministering a word of life. Jesus said to Martha, "Your brother will rise again." I speak to somebody here that it doesn't matter what has eaten up your finances or the state of your productivity. I am certain and convinced in the word of God that you will bounce back.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus told the news about the death of his friend. We are quite familiar with this account that Lazarus was a beloved of Jesus. They were what we can refer to as a family friend. And the news that Jesus got was a sad one, and the news was that his friend was at the point of death. And the news got to him again, Lazarus has passed on. It was an unfavorable evidence. It was an outcome that was not worthy of celebration. But the truth remains that Jesus turned that unfavorable condition to a favorable one. I don't know whatever condition that you are at the moment, but I'm sure that if Jesus has been registered in your heart as your comforter, that unfavorable condition will speak favor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The case of Lazarus wasn't different from the many families who have lost their loved ones to this pandemic. The case of Lazarus was not different from many who cannot afford a square meal today. Because the truth is, there are so many of us who, as at today, I don't know about yesterday, as at today, I have begun to rationalize what meal to skip to survive for tomorrow. This picture is not different from the case of Lazarus. The case of Lazarus is not different from the hopelessness of the world in their fight against COVID-19. We have come to the point where you and I can't deceive ourselves. And there is no hope in science. There's no hope in technology. This case we find ourselves is no different from the case of Lazarus. Because attempts were made, consultations were made, Jesus was sent for. We were told quite already came late. It wasn't different from the case of Lazarus. The case of Lazarus was not different from the hopelessness of Nigerians in their fight against coronavirus, in their fight against corruption virus, and in their fight against hunger virus. In the midst of all these unexplainable realities, you see corruption, you see lies within the current of power, and you see hunger is in the rising. It is not different from the case of Lazarus. There was hopelessness. Today what we see is hopelessness. Only in Jesus as our comforter we find hope. And it is my prayer that hope will come. It is my prayer that redemption will come. It is my prayer that victory will come. And I pray for you this morning, victory will be your testimony. In the name of Jesus. It was evident that Lazarus' case was already a closed chapter at Christ's arrival. It was not a closed chapter when he had the signs of what unknown to him would lead to his death. See, before you start to have malaria, I mean, you start to have signs of headache. Am I right? The death of Lazarus was a brief one. You see, that was a brief one. At that point in time, it was not a closed chapter. It was not a closed chapter when he fell sick without infirmity. Undisclosed. It was a brief illness. It was still a closed chapter when the brief illness took the better part of Lazarus. Every man that falls sick has no doubt. Every man that falls sick has no doubt that he's going to die of that sickness. There's always the belief and the hope that I'm coming out of this sickness. Perhaps Aaron has believed. That wasn't the first time perhaps he had fallen sick. There's nobody here hearing my voice that would tell me that he had never fallen sick before since he was born. We have fallen sick and we have recovered. Again and again we have recovered. Amen, somebody. But it was a closed chapter when he was registered dead. And it was confirmed that after 4 days, when Christ came to the picture, he was not buried. At that point, it became a closed chapter. Beloved, I don't know the report appearing as a closed chapter that you have been given. You have the choice to either accept the report and die, or you reject the report and fight. Whose report will I believe? There is so much report trending in the internet today that speaks of no future, but I see a future. There is so much report trending in the net today of no tomorrow after this pandemic, but I see a tomorrow. Whose report will you believe? The world and the World Health Organization continues to promote If the help of the nation, I have said it to the death sentence. Ask yourself, what did God say about it? Even if it's a death sentence, Jesus is bringing you a life sentence. Who is saying that because you are sick or I am sick or infected, I must die? After all, we've seen a sign of a victory. That not everyone who enters the isolation center comes out dead. We find many cases of people coming out alive and stronger and better. Hallelujah. Who has said that that condition will kill you or will kill me? Who has said that? The devil may have the biggest bite, but when Jesus, our comforter, steps on board, there is salvation, there is healing, there is deliverance. Who is saying that the lockdown will result to an economic meltdown, Joseph? The fear we have today now is not the fear of the virus anymore. It's the fear of what happened after this pandemic. Will business bounce back? I tell you this morning, it will bounce back. Amen. It can only take God to make 1 month for you to recover what you have lost for 9 months. You believe this morning? It can only take God 1 month to make the sales you have not made for 10 months. I believe, because Jesus is my comforter. I believe, because Jesus has said, thy weeping may endure for the night. He said, but joy comes in the morning. Like I said, not everyone who walks into the African center comes out dead. And who will say that life will be better after this evil pandemic? Beloved Christ, with determination, you and I, we can fight. I've seen cases of a man at the point of death telling me that, Pastor, I'm not going to die. Every hope of survival was lost. The man said, I know I will not die. With determination, we can fight this fight. With compliance to health regulations and hygiene, we can fight it. Because many of us, before now, we lack hygiene. Many of us, before now, we don't even brush our teeth twice a day. We don't wash our hands regularly. Environment is dirty. Everywhere is a refuse dump. Everywhere is a toilet. Our gutters are blocked. The waters in our gutters are stagnant. They are smelling. Before now, you wait for government to clear water in your compound and in front of your house. Before now. So if you've been a dirty person, wake up and fight for your life. With exercise and good eating habits, we can fight. Enough of junk. Enough of counsel. I think now we know better. This is not a time when we believe not to begin to look for direction.
ministries, or overseers and pastors to pray for us. This is a time for us to go down on our knees and pray. Like Mark prophet and pray. This is a time to go down on our knees and pray to God. The prayer before was, Lord, what has stopped letting go back to sender? Not sender anymore, because go back to sender, you and I will suffer it again. Let it die forever. This is the time for us to pray. When a boy is good, life is bad, it's a time to pray. Pray for our leaders. This is the time. Nothing is a closed chapter if Jesus has not called it so. Hear me loud and clear. Wherever you are listening to me from, Jesus has not called it yet a closed chapter. This pandemic, whatever you are going through in your life, Jesus has not called it a closed chapter. Jesus has not called you sick. He has not called you poor. He hasn't called you barren. He hasn't called you bankrupt. He hasn't called you unproductive. I pray for someone under the hearing of my voice this morning, that over that closed chapter labeled in your life, you see the new chapter. Over that womb that has refused to yield to productivity, receive fertility. Over that infirmity, journey towards becoming a terminal illness, receive your healing. Where the devil has put an end to your destiny and to the productivity of your destiny for a captivity to manifest, I see God bringing an everlasting miracle in your life. I see God bringing liberty. I see God bringing celebration. I see God bringing restoration. If I'm talking to you, celebrate just with a clap of fingers. Hallelujah, glory to God. Jesus did not go to the house of Lazarus to mark the covenant register. No. Like others did come to do. Because Jesus was not the crowd who came to mark covenant register. Oh. He was a good man. So sorry. He didn't go marking the covenant register. Jesus came as a comforter to restore life, not as a consoler to accept the fate over what has happened. Even when he was made to see reasons why what he came to do was not possible until the day of resurrection. Hear what Martha said to Jesus when Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha replied, I know that he will rise again, not today. As you have thought, you have got already late. I know he will rise again at the resurrection, at the last day. God is telling somebody here about your healing today and not for tomorrow. God is telling somebody here about your promotion today and not for tomorrow. And God is telling somebody here about your prosperity today, your deliverance today, and not for tomorrow. Hallelujah. Why should we make Jesus our comforter in a time as this? Number one, because him alone makes the supernatural possible. In the case of Daniel chapter 6, verse 16 and 17, it was simply an act of supernatural manifestation that Daniel could be in the den of lions, and lions could not feed. It is an act of the supernatural for the Hebrew men, the three Hebrew men, to be in the furnace of fire, and yet fire could not burn. It takes only the comforter to make a man comfortable in the midst of the burning fire. I don't know whatever is burning in your life, and it's pulling away the values of your productivity. An end has come today. In the name of Jesus. Number two, Him alone makes the difference. Only Jesus will lead a man, not the same way He met the man. What Jesus met at the house and at the home of Lazarus was not what He met. Jesus met a dead Lazarus, but He left a living Lazarus. Amen. Jesus met a sorrowful crowd, but He left a cheerful crowd. He met a closed chapter, but He left an open chapter. After His ministration, from rags, God is taking you to riches. From shame, He's taking you to fame. And from story, to your glory. I'm pressed down, not crushed, past the grave of Adam. Struck down, but not the strong. I'm blessed beyond the curse, for His promises will endure. For His joy that will be my strength. Though my sorrows may last for the night, joy comes in the morning. I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. Number three, Him alone never turned back on His word. Many of us have made promises that we have failed. Many have even told God, God, I will do this for you, yet we have failed. For the true comforter will not fail you. Jesus told His disciples that Lazarus was asleep, but I'm going to wake him up. His word did not return to Him empty. I speak concerning your life this morning. Every word of God concerning your life will not return empty. In the name of Jesus. Number four, Him alone is the very help in time of trouble. No condition, no infection, no affliction is bigger than the name of Jesus. The word Lazarus is from the Hebrew word which means Lazar, which means God has helped. He's not saying God will help. He didn't say God may help. The word Lazarus is Lazar, meaning God has already helped. Help us, God. But why is the pandemic help us, God? In the name of Jesus. I see help locating you this week and beyond. I see help locating your business. In the name of Jesus. Number five. He may not have the power to make the grave to yield up her tenants. I don't know whatever arrangement the enemy is making or has made to locate or allocate a grave for you this year. They have missed their target. Yeah. This year and beyond, they have missed their target. Lift your hand to the way you are and decree with me. Oh Lord, my Father, I refuse to be a tenant in the grave this year and beyond. Take it as a prayer. Lord, my Father, I refuse to be a tenant in the grave this year and beyond. If I were you, I take that prayer seriously. I refuse any member of my family to be a tenant in the grave this year. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Number six. Of our own, we can do nothing. Where are those nations bragging for world power and dominance today? Where are those nations seeking for knowledge to create life independent of God's creation? By the name of coding, robotic engineering. Man is in extinction and robots are in multiplication. Where are they today? Where are those tailoring their resources and funds to evil sponsoring evil sex like headsmen, Boko Haram, manufacturing nuclear and chemical weapons, weapon of mass destruction, and they cannot destroy coronavirus that cannot survive under the sun. It is evident today that the world has failed. Today we are living witnesses to the realities of the vanity of this world and the helplessness of man and the futility of a statement, money ahead of things. God forbid. Money does not solve things. Beloved in Christ, we must admit that we are living in a nation and the world that is in dire need of the Comforter, whose name is Jesus. For the security of life and property, for the sincerity of our leaders, for the lies that flow from the corridors of power, for the lack of public amenities by government, for the poor infrastructural and non-functional public facilities, for the registered failures by our government in meeting up with activities that will alleviate poverty in the midst of plenty, for the injustice, the headsmen, Boko Haram, kill of innocent people without justice and equity, for the yet unexplained story of the chief of elves, for poor sense of our compliance to rules and regulations of the nations as Nigerians, for the devaluation of human rights and life, and the control of premium animal rights, for doing what we ought not to have done, and living on top what we ought to have done. And for Nigerians, we must admit that we need Jesus to come comfort us. Comfort brings healing. Comfort brings the future. Comfort brings the tomorrow. Every sector of life needs the comfort of God to function to his maximum. Hence, it is my admonition, in no particular order, to our president to preside well, to our senate to senate well, to have our assembly to assemble well, to our governors govern well, House of Rep represent well, councilors counsel well, security apparatus police well, teachers teach well, pastors general overseers oversee very well. Farmers, farm well. God giving us tapas foods. Parents, parent well. Children, behave well. Businessmen, transact well. The world has been given a yellow card. You and I know what a yellow card means. The world. Not just Nigeria alone. The world has been given a yellow card. You and I never can tell when the red card will be called up. It is my prayer this morning that whatever the enemy has taken or whatever have died as a potential in our homes, in our families, in our church, in our nation, in the world, by the mercy of God, they will return back to life. In the name of Jesus. Just lift up your hands and worship the King of Kings. You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles never last away. Cause there's a friend whose name is Jesus, who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, lift your hands and say, you are my future, you are my tomorrow. In him I move. whom I live and have my being. Jesus, you are my same yesterday, today, and forever. I am unshakable, I am reliable, I am dependable. I am strong, I am immune. Because you are my Savior, you are my Savior. Visit this nation suddenly. Visit our home suddenly. Visit us with manifestations of good news, of healing, of restoration, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the answered prayers. Have your way, O Lord, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.